Hi and hello, I am Athina Pontian here. Welcome to the Basics of Biomedical Classroom once again. Today we are going to see the next topic of your fourth unit, that is Vital Parameter Study. In that we are going to discuss today is EMG, that is Electromyography. Come, let me start the class now. So, Electromyography. So what are the things we are going to discuss today about EMG is, what is EMG? The second question is, what is the purpose of that particular EMG? And how the particular EMG is acquired? And how the particular EMG is performed, that is the EMG waveform? And from the particular waveform, what is the thing we need to measure? So these are all the five different questions we need to answer today. So the first question what you are going to see is, what is EMG? This is the first question. So the three terms can be abbreviated as EMG, that is electromyography, electromyograph, electromyogram. All the things are abbreviated as EMG. Then what are the variations of these three things? This electromyography, that is the first term. The electromyography is a electrodiagnostic medicine technique. This is purposely for evaluating and recording the electrical activity of the skeletal muscle. Please remember. So that is the process called the electromyography. That is a process actually. That is a technique. For that particular technique, we are going to use the instrument called the electromyograph. Okay. From the instrument, we can able to get the graphical representation of that particular electrical activity. That is called the electromyogram. So the three terminology is, electromyography is a diagnostic technique for measuring the muscular activity, electromyograph is the instrument used for measuring the muscular activity, and electromyogram is the output that we are getting after using that particular instrument. Okay, that is a graphical representation of your muscular activity. So these three are considered as EMG. Then the next question what we are going to say is, this, what is the purpose of this EMG? So in the definition of electromyography itself, I say that is electromyography is a electrodiagnostic technique that is recorded and evaluated only for the skeletal muscle. Please remember, the muscles, we have three different muscles: skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. This particular EMG measurement is purposely for skeletal muscle. Okay, not for the smooth muscle and not for the cardiac muscle. Please remember, we are taking the electromyograph technique, we are applying the electromyograph process, all the thing only for the skeletal muscles, not for the smooth muscle and cardiac muscle. Okay, then this skeletal muscle is nothing but the bone is bind along with the muscles, or the muscles can be bind along with the bone, or called the skeletal muscles. So what is the purpose of this? See, of course, we know that what is the use of the skeletal muscle. This skeletal muscle is purposely give the support and the movement and the strength to the skeletal body. Okay, if you want to move the hand like this, if you want to walk, if you want to run, if you want to sit, whatever it is, the bone need a help of the muscles to do the function. If the person receives any pain or if the person receives any discomfort on their muscles, then the person need to have this EMG process, that is EMG technique. Need to study exactly what has happened in that particular area of the muscles. For that, this purpose of EMG is required. Okay, so there are so many muscle discomfort are there. There is muscular disorders are there. The muscles are purely connected with the nerves, sensory nerves and the motor nerves. If there is any nerves problems also, this muscle will get affected. Especially, you just take an example of the paralysis patients. Okay, their nerves are collapsed. Because due to that particular nerves collapsion, the muscles of the particular person is also getting collapsed. So this muscular and the nerves are purely binded over it along with the skeletal body. So the muscular disorder, if there is any discomfort of the particular person, whether it may be minor or major, only the thing we can able to perform or we can able to study about the particular illness by this particular EMG. If the person want to diagnose the muscles, What is that happened in that particular area? Why this particular discomfort has happened? For that particular reason, this purpose of EMG is help. Then our next question is, how this EMG is acquired? So we know that what is EMG and what is the purpose of EMG, then how we can able to acquire from the human body. Okay, if you go for any test, if you go for the EMG test, the doctor will supposed to take two different tests for acquiring EMG. One is nerve conduction test and another one is needle EMG. Please remember, nerve conduction test and this needle EMG. I already told you there is a connection between the bone, muscle and the nerves. Okay, the first test that the doctor is going to say is nerve conduction test. How the particular nerves are activated and deactivated in that particular area of the muscle. Okay, for that the doctor will do is, they are just using some of the surface electrode. They are using some of the surface electrode for measuring the nerve conduction. Okay, from the surface electrode they are just acquiring some of the electrical activity of the motor neurons. Please remember, we have the two different types of neurons, sensory neuron and motor neuron. Sensory neuron, it acquires the signal from the external, the environment. Motor neuron is nothing but it receives the signal from the brain. So, here in this nerve conduction test, they are just testing the electrical activity of the motor neuron. Whether the signal is properly coming or not in that particular area of the muscle. Okay, that is the first test they are going to take. Then the second test what they are going to do is needle EMG. Please remember, this particular needle EMG is inserted into the area where the particular person have pain, where the particular area of the person have discomfort. In that particular area, the needle electrode is nothing but the sensor, it can able to inserted into that particular area. From that particular needle electrode, they are acquiring some of the signal. Okay, that acquiring signal we can able to shows that how the muscle is activated. Okay, how we can able to test is, they are going to do the three different tests. One is, once a person is in the normal state, okay, then next is we just give some of the small effort to that particular area, then what is the graph is look like, then the little bit of forcing they are just given in that particular area, then how the particular graph is look like, then much amount of force you need to give, the doctor asks you to give, then what is the graph is look like. So the force is nothing but the way of contraction. That is a normal state. For example, if I want to take the muscular activity of this particular area, this is the normal state. If you want to give the small force, then I just little bit of compression, the little bit of contraction. Then if you want to doctor ask you to give more effort, then the powerful contraction. So that is the thing I just mentioned, that the force applied. Okay, so according to that contraction during the rest condition and the different sort of forces acting on the muscles, how the graph is look like. Okay, from that needle electrode we can able to acquire that particular graph. As an ECG, this EMG is not in the proper manner. This is fully noisy. In the ECG, we know that is a peak RST waveform, that is a proper waveform that is acquired, we can able to get from the clamp electrode or chest electrode, whatever it is. Here in this needle electrode, because of inserting into the muscles, there are so many noises we can able to acquire. At the same time, we can't able to fix a name as a peak RST waveform in ECG. Okay, irregular waveform is coming here and there. So that is very difficult to acquire what is an exact condition of the particular patient is. The only thing we can able to understand is there are so many spikes coming there. There are so many spikes coming while you are taking the EMG. While you are removing that particular noises and everything using the signal processing, we can able to get the clear activity of the muscles. The only thing we can able to draw back is, if the particular spikes is gone in the negative part, that thing shows that there is something happened, discomfort happened in the muscles. If the spike, all the thing is in the positive, then it is a normal condition. How many spikes that is moving towards in the downward direction, that shows that the muscle is not in the proper function. Okay, that is the thing you need to remember. Then the next question is, how this particular signal is look like, that is EMG signal is look like. We know that this is ECG. Okay, we have the proper diagram, proper spikes over negative and positive direction. We can able to name it as PQRST waveform like that. But here in this EMG, we don't have any proper waveforms. Because of the, we are inserting the needle inside the muscle, there are so many artifacts are forming. Artifacts are nothing but the noises around it. Okay, so many noise that is arising in the signal, that is EMG signal. So we can't able to predict the thing properly. So we can able to processing the particular signal, then only we can able to see the clear output. Okay, so here in this EMG, we can able to see so many spikes like this. There are so many spikes like this. Okay, and these particular spikes are according to the contraction and relaxation happen in the muscles of the particular region. Then the last question we are going to say is, how this particular EMG is measured? So according to the waveform, how the doctor want to diagnose? How the diagnosis process happens? See, as like as that, because this particular variations is happened because of the contraction and relaxation. If you are contracted, then the spikes come over. Then the relaxed, then the spikes comes minimum. Like that, it attains the waveform. So here, the spike should be in the positive direction, the most important thing. The number of spikes that is indicated in the upward direction, that is a normal condition. If the person have spikes in the denominator, that is in the negative of the y-axis, then that indicates there is some of the problem that has happened in that particular area of the muscle. So this is how the particular doctor can able to measure. So according to that measurement, how the particular muscle activities happen, how far this particular muscles is damaged, it indicates that the negative spikes over in the downward direction of the y-axis. Okay, so this is how we can able to measure the EMG activity. So this is what a small description about electromyograph. Okay, as a biomedical engineer, you should know that all this part, that is what is EMG, what is the purpose of EMG, and how the particular EMG is acquired, and how the particular EMG is EMG graph is look like, and how to measure from the particular graph. So this is the basic thing you need to know regarding the EMG. So in the next class, what you are going to discuss about is the next vital parameter, EEG. Thank you very much.